Airstrikes have hit Lebanon's north for the first time amid Israel's claims more than 400 Hezbollah operatives have been killed since its ground invasion began. It comes as tonight thousands of Australians desperately rushed to escape the fighting.
While we were sitting in the airplane just before takeoff, there was a lot of bombing, like around 500 metres next to the airport.
We travelled about 4 hours to get to the airport, to Beirut Airport, and we're just hoping we don't encounter anything too dangerous along the way.
Hundreds of evacuated Aussies have touched down in Cyprus.
I was traumatised. My kids were traumatised as well. It's not a safe country.
A lot of bombing's going on over there.
We had to evacuate without our parents.
They're exhausted, exceptionally happy to be here, but heartbroken because they've left family behind.
Our Defence Minister confirming almost 500 Australians have been brought to safety this week after the government secured repatriation flights out of the capital.
This is the time to leave. The airport remains open, which is a blessing. It's really important that people take the opportunity to leave.
The situation in Lebanon has been very, very difficult, especially on the roads. On our way to the airport, Beirut is the hotspot of bombing, so the journey would be very uncertain and filled with fears.
Overnight, more explosions rocked Beirut. Local media reporting five more Israeli strikes hit the city's south, four of them, quote, very violent. While a separate blast hit the northern city of Tripoli for the first time since the conflict broke out.
I would say that people are traumatized. People have been losing their homes and their families, children losing their parents, trying to find shelter.
It's time for the release of the hostages, time to silence the guns, time to stop the suffering that has engulfed the region.
But as Israel plots its retaliation against Iran for a missile strike earlier this week, the region is bracing for more bloodshed.
Israel is defending civilizations against those who seek to impose a dark age of fanaticism on all of us. Israel will fight until the battle is won, for our sake and for the sake of the peace and security of the entire world.
David Wood is a journalist and a senior analyst for the International Crisis Group. He joins us now from about an hour's drive north of Beirut. David, there are reports hospitals have had to close after bombings on Friday. How dire are things getting there?
So that's correct, that at least four hospitals in Lebanon have needed to shut in the past 24 hours. And this is a key reminder that these strikes that are being carried out by Israel are happening in civilian areas. It's also concerning that Israel stated that it would be targeting certain medical vehicles if it believes that they're carrying Hezbollah weapons or members, which is something similar to what we heard in Gaza from late last year when similar attacks were made on medical vehicles based on the same allegations. So it's a very concerning thing when you note that, I mean, Lebanon has been going through a crippling economic crisis as well. So even before this war, the medical system had seen thousands of doctors leave the country. So even though there's been real efforts to prepare the medical system to deal with the impact of an expanded war, it's clearly a massive humanitarian disaster could be on the way if these attacks on medical facilities continue.
Why is Israel targeting medical vehicles?
So, according to the Israeli army, medical vehicles, because they would be seen as something that's a target that should not be hit, are being used by Hezbollah, and the allegation was made in Gaza as well about Hamas, that they would use these vehicles as cover for transporting their members and weapons.
How significant is it that Israel expanded its strikes to the northern city of Tripoli? That's happened for the first time.
So we know that the strike was a targeted strike directed against a Hamas commander, and it succeeded in killing the commander and his family. Now, the fact that it was targeted means that up until now, there's not a plan to, it would seem, launch wide-scale bombings in a city like Tripoli, which is the second biggest city in Lebanon. It's also worth remembering, though, that in 2006, Israel did have widespread bombing campaigns that it launched across the country directed at key civilian infrastructure. So we know that Israel has started its ground incursions into southern Lebanon. Now, at the minute, it says that they will remain limited targeted raids against Hezbollah infrastructure. But if that ground invasion expands and there's a more permanent presence of Israeli troops in southern Lebanon, then there could be a scenario where Israel decides that it needs to attack civilian infrastructure to cut off supplies to southern Lebanon, just as an example. So that could include the port in Tripoli. It could also include the international airport in Beirut as well.
David, thanks so much for your update. We appreciate your time.
No worries. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Cheers.